How are you feeling? You got John Riggs here, and this right here is the Oculus Quest. Is this worth $500 of your hard-earned cash? Well, in this video, I want to cover the hardware, I want to cover a few of the games that I played from the get-go, and even some of my gripes, and I actually have several of them for something like this. But all those things aside, is it worth 500 bucks? We're gonna find out. Now, the Oculus Quest is this. It's all in here. Now, I do love my PlayStation VR, but unlike the PlayStation VR, which requires a PlayStation 4, everything you need is all in the headset. So, nice thing to know that you can just get one of these and go to town on it. I don't have a PC good enough, I don't think, to operate like an Oculus or something like that. But for something like this, you don't need a PC. It's all in the headset. That's pretty cool. Now, up in these corners here, those are basically your camera. It kind of casts out to see where you are, and then that's what gives you the depth. And talking about 6 degrees of freedom. Now, you'll see 3 degrees of freedom, 6 degrees of freedom. 3 degrees of freedom is like you can move like left and right, up and down, 360 and all that. Even in VR, like, you know, 3D depth. But you can't move forward or back. It'll look the same, you know, whether you do that. However, this makes it so you can actually take a step forward, and in game you take a literal step forward in the video game. In fact, with this, when you first sign onto it, you have to draw a boundary of your safety zone. Now here in the video, I'm doing this outside. Yeah, you can actually play this outside if you'd like. So this is my front little patio area. Just draw a boundary. Now I don't want to step on the plants, so I'm going to draw around that too. And if you get close to that border, then a virtual wall will kind of show up saying, hey, wait a minute, this is going to go beyond your boundary here. So something to keep in mind. Now it uses USB-C both for charging and for dumping off videos, because you can also capture videos, both pictures and video, using this device here. Also got a headphone jack here, as well as the other side too. Whatever you're more comfortable with, I suppose. Power button, nice and sleek right there. Nothing really on top. And then underneath you have your volume up and down, as well as your slider control. This thing does have a built-in microphone and built-in speakers, so you don't need to wear a microphone to hear it. You can just kind of hear it in the outer space. However, it might be optimized for you to use headphones when you do wear something like this. Also, I don't know if you saw my unboxing video, but there is a spacer if you wear prescription glasses, so it's not so close up to the lenses on this thing. So you can actually put a spacer between the device and the cushion to give yourself a little bit of extra space for you, those of you like me who wear prescription glasses. It comes with these. These are your controllers, and I think these are very, very comfortable. I'm extremely happy with these. It comes with the wrist straps too. Make sure you have your wrist straps, especially when you're playing some of those like boxing games and stuff like that too. You got a trigger here. You also have a grip button right there. And then both of them on the inside have two buttons, an analog, which also acts as another button, and then a menu selection as well as the Oculus button. The Oculus button kind of goes to your home screen, your title screen, your personal screen that says whether you want to record something, take a picture. If you hold it down, you'll center yourself. Like on PlayStation VR, if you hold the start button for 2 seconds, you reposition yourself. That's what that button does too. So very, very handy, and again, super, super light and comfortable. Something to keep in mind is they both use a single AA battery. There is no way to charge these. You have to use a AA battery. Not the end of the world, but would have been nice if you could charge them. Now, to put it on your head, it does have these adjustable straps, which can be comfortable. However, if you're like me and have a giant cranium, I literally have to use the last button of my snapbacks to wear a ball cap or something like that. Even at the very, very end, it fits pretty well, but it's still kind of a tight squeeze, kind of a tight snug, which you kind of want for something like this, because you don't want it falling off your head, right? The other thing, before I put these on, is these glasses are not comfortable with something like this. Because of how far these stick out, it's pushing up against it more than I would like, and it kind of hurts the bridge of my nose. So fortunately, I do have another pair of glasses that do work. Man, I haven't worn these glasses for like 5 years. However, it's the same prescription. They work just fine. And to place it on, these also kind of prop upward like that. I suggest putting it on like such and then dropping that down. And that right there is a sexy beast. Because I have the extra chipmunk cheek thing going on, I can see down a little bit. So it's not completely snug over my face. And also because the computer's all up in here, it's pretty top-heavy. It's a little more top-heavy than I would have liked. Again, I'm used to the PlayStation 4, but the PlayStation 4 doesn't have all these extra components up in the front. So I'm not as used to it. Not the end of the world, but with my chubby cheeks, and this is my own fault, this right here, that's all me. I need to work on that to get maybe a more comfortable fit. However, it's not the end of the world. Now, it's not like you're going to be playing a whole lot on this in the first place, all in one sitting, because with the charger, with the battery life, you're looking at about a 2 hour battery life on something like this. Now, again, for me, that's fine. I'm usually not playing any video game of any kind for more than 2 hours in a row. However, there have been those gaming marathons, trust me, I've been there too, where that's all you're doing for 2 hours, and you do not want to play it while it's plugged in. That kind of takes away from the whole VR, you know, it takes away from what the Quest is all about, being wireless and cordless, right? I would recommend trying out those shorter experiences for sure with something like this. But yeah, a 2 hour battery life, certainly that can be improved upon. Now, I also say this thing was $500, and you're like, I thought it was like $400? Well, it can be. The $399 model is the 64 gig. I opted for the 128 gig, which does go for an extra $100. To me, it's worth it because, again, this is an all-digital system. There are no physical games that'll ever come out for the Oculus Quest. So when you keep that in mind, it's going to be all digital. You can delete the games you don't need and re-download them later if you'd like using your Oculus account. To me, it was worth the extra $100. You know, and that instead of something else. But unfortunately, there is no other USB port way of expanding the memory. So I'm not sure how or if that can even be a possibility later on down the road. So never mind the 2 hour battery life. Never mind the literal AA batteries in the controllers. Never mind that it squishes my glasses up against my face, so I have to wear these 5-year-old glasses. That's just for me personally, maybe not for the glasses you wear. There are some pretty cool features and there are some pretty cool games on this that maybe aren't available for the PlayStation 4. There are some PlayStation 4 games on this too, but I want to cover a few games. Here's what I've played so far on the Oculus Quest. Now, the very first game I had to check out was Vader Immortal. Now, I paid $10 for this game. It was $9.99, and all I knew about this game was it takes place in the Star Wars universe and you can wield a lightsaber. That's all I needed to know. What I didn't know is this is obviously Chapter 1. It's a pretty short experience, but to me, 100% worth the $10 investment to check this game out because it works wonderfully. It's a great introduction to the Oculus Quest. It does have some things where you can look around a little bit, maybe take a step here, take a step there to give you that room ability. And of course, when you do get that lightsaber, and not only are you like, you know, slashing guys, but you're also like, you know, deflecting bullets back to stormtroopers and all that too. Super, super fun experience. And nothing is more scarier or creepier than being face to face with Darth Vader.
I sense a latent force ability within you.
If you're getting an Oculus Quest, Vader Immortal is, to me, a must, and I'm looking forward to the next chapter already. Now, I'm familiar with Rec Room, but I've heard so much about VR Chat, and VR Chat is free to download on your Oculus Quest. What VR Chat has that Rec Room doesn't have is they have custom avatars that other people have made. So you can walk around as, well, you can see the characters here. You don't need me to tell you. You can also go to other worlds that people have made, and this room here looks very familiar. Interactive too, you can go bowling if you'd like. And if you're wondering what avatar I chose just to start out with, gotta go with my man Schnitzel. Gotta go with my homie Schnitzel. I love the cartoon Chowder. You can also have different avatars on tap too, so when you're done with one of them, hey, why not switch over to Isabel from Animal Crossing? Now, I don't know what it is. I've always been a huge geek for maps. I remember as a child, I would actually read the Rand McNally's Road Atlas just for fun. And Wander is a $10 app. It's $9.99. And it's basically Google Street View in VR. You can go wherever you want and then look around in VR. You can go to random places. You can pull up a map and just choose where you want to go. You can also click the microphone button and with the microphone, speak into where you want to go. I can just say, like, Space Needle. You'll go to the Space Needle. And like magic, you'll be whisked away to Seattle Center, where looming above you, representing the World's Fair 1964, at your Space Needle. So if you've never seen the Space Needle, what it looks like when you're standing on the ground, man, there you go. You can also go to other places too, like mountaintops, to look down and stuff like that too. Very, very cool. And a little virtual sightseeing there with Wander. I like it. Another free experience I downloaded was called Oculus First Contact. Kind of like a job simulator. It just kind of gets you used to the controls. It gets you used to how to grab something, control something, look around, wave. I like the robot on here. It reminds me of Rob from Nintendo. You know, it was another free app. It was another free app to download, so may as well check it out, right? And this one is right up my kid's alley. It's called Bogo. It's basically a virtual pet that you can do different things with. Like, you know, you can play catch. You can brush its dirty face. You can, you know, do stuff with it, interact with it. And I know these screens don't show it justice, but when you're right there, I mean, this thing is huge. And Epic Roller Coasters is a free download you can check out. There's a couple of free levels, however, you can pay for extra ones. Think of it as a more tame version of Until Dawn's Rush of Blood for the PlayStation VR. It's a roller coaster journey. You can either just ride the roller coaster and enjoy the ride. You can shoot little targets if you'd like. Yeah, it's not a bad experience. I'm happy they have this on here. And on top of all that, you have Beat Saber. You have Creed Rise to Glory. There are some other Oculus games that I still have yet to check out. I just haven't purchased them yet. And then more games coming out here in the near future. So this thing here, I had my gripes, man. 2-hour battery life, like I said. The controllers use AA batteries. It squishes my glasses up against my face. It's a little top heavy, squeezes my cheeks down, kind of pulls them down a little bit. Still, I like it. It's a good step in the right direction because I do believe, now, is VR going to be the future of gaming? I don't think so. I don't think anything will take away video games from being shown on a monitor of some sort without using the headset. However, I do like the immersiveness that you can do with VR. I do like a lot of things that you can do with VR that you can't do with just like a console game system or even a PC or a Mac with the VR element. So I think it's its own idea. It's its own, kind of like how mobile gaming is its own gaming. You know what I mean? I think VR gaming, like mobile gaming, like console gaming, is its own universe. It's its own entity. And this is a step in the right direction because I do believe that the future of VR gaming is not going to have any wires and cords attached to it. That's what takes you away from being immersed in these wonderful universes that people are creating. I think it's cool. I think I'm okay with it. $500 is a pretty steep price point. However, for me, something like this, I think it's pretty cool. And this is not an ad or an endorsement. I did not receive this for free from the Oculus company. I actually paid for this. However, I'm glad I did. And I'm looking forward to seeing what the next level of VR is going to be. Maybe the PlayStation VR 2 will be all wireless. At this point, I hope it does. Because if it doesn't, the PlayStation VR 2 is going to fail. If it's not wireless. That's my opinion, though. Something like this, it's a step in the right direction. I'm looking forward to seeing what else they can do with it. Maybe even smaller components to make it a lot lighter. I don't know what else I would do to make it lighter. I mean, outside of like putting all the computer components in a thing that you can wear in your pocket. But then again, that would take away from all of this, right? You just want it all in here. So I think it's pretty cool. I encourage you to check it out if you see maybe a display or something like that somewhere else. I would recommend trying it first before purchasing it for yourself. If you're interested in yours, of course, I have a link in the description below. I thank you for watching, and I'm looking forward to seeing what other Oculus games are out there. If you have any suggestions, make sure you hit me up in the comments below.